an important area, that is duty drawback. Duty drawback and baggage, from these two, one question will be asked in every attempt. Okay. Now, duty drawback is what? Refund. Duty drawback means refund. Simply remember, duty drawback is refund. When you will get that refund? In three situations, you will get that refund. What are those three situations? Imported goods are exported as such without use. You will get refund. Imported goods are exported as such without use. You will get refund. Duty drawback, section 74, subsection 1. Example, you are importing, you know, a robot for display in an exhibition. Once the exhibition is over, that robot, you are exporting it back. So, imported goods exported as such without use. 74 subsection 1, duty drawback. Imported goods exported as such after use. What does it mean? That is, you have imported some goods and those imported goods are exported. As such means what you imported also exported, but after use. Example, say racing cars. You are importing racing cars for conducting a race here. Once the race is conducted, you are sending it back. In that case, we will be getting 74 subsection 2, duty drawback. Imported goods are exported as such after use. After use. In that case, 74 subsection 2. Got it? And then, imported goods are used in manufacture of finished goods and then exported. Say you imported some integrated circuits or motherboard, etc. You made laptops and you are exporting it. So, imported goods used in manufacture of finished goods and then exported, you will get duty drawback under 75. So, three cases. Imported goods exported as such without use, 74 subsection 1. Imported goods exported as such after use, 74 subsection 2. And imported goods used in manufacture of finished goods which are then exported, section 75. These are the three sections under which we will get duty drawback. Now, input tax credit versus duty drawback. Remember that in case of 74, we will get duty drawback, 74 subsection 1, 74 subsection 2, that covers even IGST component also. Now, let's take an example to understand. As per 74 subsection 1, if imported goods are exported as such without use, 98% of the customs duty paid on import you will get as a refund. Now, at the time of import you paid basic customs duty, social welfare surcharge, IGST, etc. Now, upon export you will get 98%. Is this 98% calculated on the total customs duty or only on the basic customs duty? Calculated on the total customs duty, not only on the basic customs duty, total customs duty including IGST. Now, can you claim IGST refund under GST? No, you should not claim IGST refund under GST. But in case of section 75, whenever you are exporting, a percentage of FOB value of export, how much ever you paid customs duty, leave it. But a percentage of FOB value of export will be given to as a duty drawback covering only the customs duty component but not IGST component. Which means, can we claim input tax credit with respect to that IGST and can we get the refund? Yes. So, IGST refund is possible under GST in case of 75 scenario, but not in case of 74 scenario. See this. In case of section 74, duty drawback covers IGST and GST compensations is paid on import. Therefore, ITC cannot be availed with respect to the same. However, in case of section 75, duty drawback covers only customs duty but not IGST and GST compensations. So, ITC can be availed with respect to the same and we can claim refund of unutilized ITC, okay, upon export. Then, now first we are completing all the provisions related to 74 and thereafter we will come to 75. First, as per 74, what is the time limit within which the goods must be exported? The imported goods must be exported within 2 years from the date of payment of customs duty on import. It is not 2 years from the date of import. 2 years from the date of payment of customs duty on import. Suppose if the goods are kept in the warehouse and we will be clearing it from the warehouse upon payment of customs duty, from that date 2 years should be counted, not from the date of import. Okay. And it can be extended for a further period of whatever that is prescribed by CBIC. and then rates of duty drawback 98% in case of 74 subsection 1. 98% of what? Customs duty paid on import. What is 74 subsection 1? Imported goods are exported as such without use. Whatever is the total customs duty paid, out of the total customs duty paid, 98% we will get as duty drawback. Okay, 98% of the customs duty paid at the time of importation, we will get as a duty drawback. Okay, whereas in case of 74 subsection 2, duty drawback at reduced rates, there are some notified rates. What are those notified rates? What are those notified rates? See this. The notified rates depends here. Duty drawback rates as per 74 subsection 2. If it is motor vehicles imported by any person or goods imported by an individual for personal purpose, in that case, we need to take total customs duty paid as reduced by 4% for every quarter or part thereof in the first year and 2.5% for every quarter or part thereof in the second year, 2% for every quarter or part thereof in the third year, and 2% like first 4, 3, 2.5 and 2. For example, say it is used for 2 years, 1 month. If it is used for 2 years, 1 month, 2 years, so first year, 4 into 4, 16%. Second year, 3 into 4, 12%. So therefore, 16 plus 12, 28%. Plus 1 month in the third year, part thereof, so therefore 2.5%. So 28 plus 2.5%, 30.5%. Okay. So now, motor vehicle for any use. Yes, motor vehicle imported by any person for any use, whereas any other goods imported by individual for personal purpose. So that's how we need to calculate. Suppose if you are using it for full 4 years, how much duty drawback you will be getting? First year 16%, second year 12%, third year 10%, fourth year, you know, 8%. So that much you will get, that much you should deduct, and balance you will get as duty drawback. What if you are exporting after 4 years? Zero. You will not get any duty drawback. After 4 years, you will not get any duty drawback. By fourth year, if you export, that much duty drawback you will get. After 4 years, you will not get any duty drawback. Okay. Then next. Sir, but the permitted time itself is 2 years now, sir. Yes, permitted time itself is 2 years. So within the 2 years, it should be exported. If not, it can be extended, but that extended cannot go beyond 4 years. That is the meaning of that statement. Okay. And then suppose if it is other cases, if it is other case, so when this discussion will be applicable, that is customs duty paid minus this 4%, 3%, 2.5 and 2, if it is motor vehicle imported by any person for any use, and whereas if it is any other goods imported by an individual for personal purpose, in other cases, normal, then depending upon the period of usage, you will get duty drawback. What is that period of usage? So you increase the usage period for every 3 months, 0 to 3, 3 to 6, 6 to 9, 9 to 12, 12 to 15, 15 to 18, more than 18, you will not get duty drawback. And it starts at 95%. It comes down by 10%, 95, 85, 75, 65. Like that, it comes down by 10% up to 75%. Thereafter, it comes down by 5%. So first it starts with 95. Then it will get reduced by 10% up to 75, and thereafter it will come down by 5%. So 70, 65 and 60. So this is how we will be calculating duty drawback under 74 subsection 2. 74 subsection 2. Say for example, we are using it for 11 months. 11 months means it will come under 9 to 12. So 9 to 12, what is the duty drawback? 70%. So 70% of total custom duty paid, we will get as duty drawback. That's how we will calculate this. Now, these are the notified rates here. Then, mandatory prohibition. Duty drawback less than 50 rupees, you will not get the duty drawback. So, the minimum duty drawback will be 50. And market price of export goods is less than the duty drawback. What is this? That is, you are exporting some goods. When you are exporting some goods, you are required to get some duty drawback. But the value of those exported goods is less than the duty drawback. Okay, for example, you see this. Value of the imported goods is 1 lakh. Customs duty paid on that is 30%, 30,000. Now, you are exporting it is, you are exporting it as such without use after few months. So how much you will get as duty drawback? As such without use. As such without use means you will be getting 98%. So therefore 30,000 into 98%, 29,400. But its market value is just 20,000 now. So you will not get duty drawback. Why? Because the amount of duty drawback is more than the market value. So you will not get duty drawback in this case. So these are the two prohibitions applicable with respect to this. Then in case of 75, in case of section 75, if the duty drawback is less than 50, you will not get the duty drawback. If the amount of duty drawback is less than 50, you will not get the duty drawback. And if the market price of the export goods is less than duty drawback also, you will not get duty drawback. Market price, same point. So same point, market value of the exported goods less than duty drawback, you will not get duty drawback. Apart from this, so there is one example also in this regard, that is value of exported goods in Indian market is 30,000. So whatever you are exporting, that market value is 30,000 and the FOB value declared is somewhere 4 lakhs. See, 30,000 rupees worth of goods you are declaring as 4 lakhs. Now the duty drawback is 10% of FOB, say 40,000, but you will not get duty drawback because the market value of the export goods is less than the amount of duty drawback, so you will not get duty drawback. Then next prohibition is that maximum duty drawback is equal to 1/3 of the market price. What is the difference between previous point and this point? In previous point, the market value is less than duty drawback. Now the market value is more than duty drawback, you will get that duty drawback, but the maximum duty drawback that you will get is 33.13% of the market value. For example, export price is 1 lakh. Its market value is 50,000. You will get a duty drawback 1 lakh into 30%, because in case of 75, you will get duty drawback as a percentage of export value. You will get duty drawback as a percentage of export value. Okay. So therefore, we need to take FOB into 30%. That is the duty drawback you will get, 30,000. But what is the maximum duty drawback? 1/3 of the market price. So market price is what? 50,000, means 1/3. So only 16,667 you will get as duty drawback. You know how 75 works. 75 is irrespective of the custom duty paid on import. Whatever may be your export value, on that a percentage will be given to you as duty drawback. Then rule 8. No duty drawback allowed if the value of the export goods is less than the value of imported goods or imported material used therein. Okay. So generally, what is this? Negative value addition. Negative value addition means whatever is your FOB value of export, that should be greater than the CIF value of the import, because there cannot be negative value addition. There should be a positive value addition. Even if it is equal to also, it is okay. If the FOB value of exports is greater, should be greater than or equal to CIF value of import. Okay. Then next, no duty drawback allowed if value of export goods is not more than notified percentage of the value of imported materials used. What is that? That is, you have imported some materials and you are exporting it. You are using it in manufacture of finished goods which are exported. Say there is a notified percentage. For example, 10% is notified. Means if your FOB value of export should be 10% more than the CIF value of import. Your FOB value of export should be 10% more than the CIF value of import. In that case, that 10% is there, right? The 10%. So you should achieve. And it should be greater than the 10%. Means really your FOB value of export should be greater than the 10%. Suppose if it is less than or equal to the 10%, you will not get duty drawback if it is notified. What is the difference between previous point and this point? In previous point, they did not notify the percentage. But in this case, if percentage is notified, you should exceed that percentage notified. If the percentage is not notified, if you ensure that the FOB value of export is greater than or equal to CIF value of import, that is sufficient. Okay. Then, so here, appeals related information for determination of market value, all these things are not applicable in your exam, because appeals related provisions under customs or other aspects are not there. Okay. Then discretionary prohibition. What is this discretionary prohibition? Discretionary prohibition means the goods are exported and are likely to be imported back to India. In that case, they will not sanction duty drawback. Many people, what they will do? They will import from developed countries. They will be sending it to the neighboring countries and bringing it in a land route. So therefore, the goods in the namesake for records imported and exported, we will get duty drawback. But those goods would have been circulating in India. So in that case, they may not give duty drawback in both the cases. Identity satisfaction. Should we prove that identity is satisfied in case of 74? Yes, because in case of 74, the imported goods and the exported goods should be same. But in case of 75, definitely it is different goods. So identity satisfaction not required. So this is mainly in case of duty drawback. And 75, listen, in case of 75, there are three types of rates. There is no time limit for export. In case of 75, there is no time limit for export. And there are three types of rates: all industry rate, brand rate, and special brand rate. All industry rate means they will notify the goods and what is the duty drawback rate. Whereas brand rate means when there is no all industry rate notified, you will make an application for brand rate. And special brand rate is when duty drawback as per notified all industry rate is less than 80% of the total customs duty payable, then application will be made for special brand rate. So whatever is the duty drawback as per notified all industry rate we are getting is less than 80% of the customs duty paid on import, in that case we will be getting, you know, so we can make an application for special brand rate. But remember, once you already made application for all industry rate, once already you got a duty drawback as per all industry rate, you cannot go for special brand rate. Means you should not claim any benefit under all industry rate, then only you can make application for special brand rate. So less than 80% of the customs duty paid on import, then only you can go for special brand rate. So that is this. See this. Special brand rate, when duty drawback under all industry rate is less than 80% of the actual duties or tax incidents. What is duty drawback schedule? Duty drawback schedule means, so there is a tariff that is fixed, that is for which product, what is the rate of duty drawback, that is known as duty drawback schedule. So that duty drawback schedule, which we don't have to learn, because that duty drawback schedule will run into some 800 pages. So that 800 pages, what we will learn, which product, what is the rate, we cannot run. So that will be given in the exam itself as to what is the rates for the duty drawback schedule, that is that particular product which you are exporting. Suppose the product which you are exporting is not having a rate, then we will make application for brand rate. So this is with respect to this. So we need to go for either all industry rate or special brand rate, not both. Once we make application for all industry rate, we cannot go for special brand rate. And when we can go for special brand rate? Only when the duty drawback as per all industry rate, how do we know, we need to compute, is less than 80% of the customs duty paid on import, then we will make an application for special brand rate. So this is about duty drawback here. So with this, duty drawback is over.